don't know if you can see what I can see, but it's fantastic looking out. You can see those Union Jacks and those George Crosses. God bless them. Now, before saying anything else, there's just, there will be people in this crowd today with buckets collected on the behalf of a gorgeous, beautiful little two-year-old girl called Amelia May Davis. Now, unfortunately and tragically, she passed away early last week, and we attended the funeral on Wednesday, myself and Tommy, representing the English Defence League, because all you beautiful people helped raise money, thousands and thousands of pounds, to try and save this beautiful little girl, but unfortunately it came too late. And not because of us, not because of lack of trying or effort from decent human beings like you, myself and Tommy, to put all the hard work in, their family, their uncles and sort of son. They ran 250 miles in 5 days. An amazing feat. They tried everything they could to raise the money. They wrote to every politician, of every person in Westminster, their MPs, and they never even got a response back. They just don't care. Now this beautiful girl, I'm just going to hold this up for you. Now this sickness runs deep, and it runs hard right through Westminster. And all these lefties and all these unions, Labour government, they are all incredibly sick with this sickness, cowardice. They are all spineless. Out of the whole 650 politicians in Westminster, there's not enough bone in the whole lot of them to make one single spine. I've said it before you become a politician in this country, I'm sure there's a surgical procedure that you have to undergo to have your spine removed and replaced with a jellyfish before you get the job. Now, you're all aware that the Health for Heroes and other charities, they declined our money that we raised because they decided to play political football with the likes of Amelia May's life. And with our money that we were trying to raise, and all the good people were raising to help the heroes. So because of they trying to take the high ground, Amelia May's family have now started the Amelia May Foundation because of the hassle they had with the charity. So from now on, we here as Defence League are going to take up the challenge and take this on as a quest for ourselves. We are going to be part of the Amelia May Foundation. And we, the people who have these poor blind children, and shame our government for doing that. Where's all these banners? Hold up banners! Get all these banners up in the air! Show them, let the lefty media see these banners! Let the media see these banners and what they say! Al Qaeda, alive and well in Birmingham! Patriotism is not racism! Denying your race is treason! The UAF will never silence us! Support our troops! The Riyadh Jihad flag of war! The police are allowing them to carry that and to burn our flags! Inciting racial hatred and hate crime. How come it's being allowed? Well, they're just scum and we won't let them. And together we have formed the English Defence League, which has become a global movement. Global! Yeah, how can we? They can never, ever stop us now. And they'll never stop us. Now, there was always a lot of talk about myself and Tommy, about our heritage, the fact that we're from this descent, that descent, Irish descent, Scottish descent. Well, we are the English Defence League, but we are still Great Britain. We've got the most defence team here today. We've got the Scottish Defence League here today. Girls, absolutely fantastic, love them to bits. We've got got the worst defence team. We've got the worst taking losses. We are still the union. Although we are England and we love the George Cross, we still love that Union Jack because together we are strong. And the only way that we can do this is if we let them divide us. We cannot allow them to divide us. This breaking up of the union, it cannot be allowed to happen. We must keep that Union Jack. It represents us all. That's how we fought off everybody that attempted to take this island together. Now, a lot of videos and a lot of idiots spreading rumours and gossip about myself and Tommy, about the fact that we're Irish this, we're Irish that. What a load of old poppycock! We started this thing 4 years ago, and we started it through pride, passion and belief. And for the love of the Union Jack, and for the George Cross, and the love for our troops. That's why we started it, because we were so outraged at how it's insulted, how they insulted our flags, how they insulted our soldiers. And there's been a lot of talk about ourselves. And I just want to show you something. This is my most prized possession. And I'll share this with you. As did Tommy's granddad, my grandfather won these five medals. He fought from 1939 to 1945. He only had two leaves during those whole 6 years, and he was a sergeant. He didn't take those leaves. He gave them to two younger men under his command who had family. For this British, for this shores, for this England, for Britain, for that Union Jack. For that Union Jack. He took human life against the Nazis. And he was bloody good at it as well. And these are my most prized possessions. I didn't have to bring them, but I just...